In this video, we're going to talk about what Assistive Touch is in terms of an iOS device, how to set up Assistive Touch. We're going to see it in action, and we're going to go through some usage scenarios. We're going to use three different types of visual indicators. We'll use a hand every time I tap. Every time I hit a button on the outside of the device, we'll give you an icon. And we're going to use arrows to help point out key information on screen. Apple says Assistive Touch lets you enter multi-touch gestures using one finger or a stylus. It also supports the use of adaptive input devices like headsets and switches. You can think of Assistive Touch as a way of interfacing with the iPad when the normal keys or buttons won't work for you. You can also use Assistive Touch to sort of shortcut through the use of compound gestures the process of navigating the iPad. Here's how to set up Assistive Touch. Tap the Settings app. Tap General. Scroll down until you find Accessibility and tap Accessibility. Scroll down again until you find Assistive Touch and tap Assistive Touch. So now you're in the Settings application under the General tab, under the Accessibility tab, under the Assistive Touch tab. Here, you want to tap and slide the Assistive Touch slider and turn it on. You're going to notice two things. A little button appeared on the right-hand side, and custom gestures settings appeared. Let me focus on the button first. This button is the way that you activate Assistive Touch, and there are eight positions for the button. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And they will slide into place if you let go. The other thing that's interesting about the button, I'm going to go to the home page and I'll show this to you. When I go to search, so I'm going to slide and search, you'll notice that the home button, that the Assistive Touch button automatically came up and moved out of the way of the keyboard. So it's an intelligent button and it'll try to stay out of your way until you need it. I'm going to show you how to record a custom gesture for Assistive Touch. Tap on the Settings app, tap on the Generals tab, and then tap and scroll down to get to Accessibility. Tap on Accessibility. Tap and scroll down until you get to Assistive Touch. And under the Assistive Touch tab, you'll see Create New Gesture. So tap on that. And then you're given a screen where you can, anytime you touch it, you'll record a gesture, and then you can save that. So I'm going to record a flick up gesture, which allows me to scroll down the screen. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to tap down and flick up. And you can see that it automatically went into record mode and recorded that gesture, and you can see it on screen. I'm going to now stop and then play back that gesture to make sure that's what I want. And that is what I want. Now, in the upper right-hand corner, I'm going to hit save. And it'll give me a dialog. So I'm going to type in something meaningful. And this actually, when I'm in like a web browser or I'm even in the settings menu, it actually allows me to scroll down. So I'm going to call this scroll down. Down, and I'm going to hit save. And now you can see scroll down in my custom gestures menu item. If I wanted to delete it, let's say I made a mistake or I no longer need it, all I have to do at this point is hit the edit button, which is in the upper right hand corner, and then tap the do not enter sign basically, and then tap on delete. I'm not going to do that right now because I want to show you how it works, but that's all I have to do to delete is by tapping on delete. Before I do a tour of the extensive menuing system of Assistive Touch, I want to talk a little bit about the actual menu itself and how it works. In order to activate the menu, tap on the little white button, and in my case, it's on the right-hand side, so I'm going to tap on that. You'll see four items in that button. The top three items actually lead into other menus, and we'll get into that in a second. One of the things that's not apparent, though, is let's talk about exiting out first of Assistive Touch. I can tap anywhere outside of the menu itself, and that will exit out of Assistive Touch. So I've just tapped on the home screen, and it exited out. So that's one item. The second item that I want you to know, and I'm going to launch Assistive Touch again, is that in the middle, especially when you get into gestures, both custom gestures and stock gestures, to deactivate a gesture, you tap in the center of the menu, and that also will turn the menu off. So it does two things. It deactivates a gesture and turns the menu off. So that's really important. The other thing you'll note, for those of you familiar with iOS 5, this is a beta version of iOS 6, and the Assistive Touch menu is much larger in this version in the new iOS 6 than it is in the old iOS 5. And there's also some new menu items, so I want to talk about that. Now let's get into a little bit of action here. So the first thing you're going to see is the home button at the bottom. If I were to tap on it, which I will do right now, it does exactly what the physical home button does. So I tap on it, and notice that it moved me from the home screen. It shut down the Assistive Touch menu. It moved me from the home screen to the search pad. And this is exactly the same behavior as if I were touching on the physical home button, and I will show you. I'm going to tap and scroll over to the home page, and I'm now going to tap on the physical home button, tap, and you'll see that it did exactly what I did when I did with the Assistive Touch menu. The next submenu I want to focus on in the Assistive Touch is the gesture submenu. So I'm going to tap on Assistive Touch to activate the main menu, and then tap on gestures. And I'm presented with five options. I can either mimic a two-finger, three-finger, four-finger, or five-finger gesture, or I can use the arrow key to get back out of the menu system. So I have multi-touch turned on, and so if I use four fingers on screen and swipe upwards, I will then be able to get the multitask bar. So I'm going to show you how to do that with one finger. So I'm going to use one finger to tap on the four-finger gesture, and you can see on screen I have four fingers, one, two, three, and I'm going to tap and flick up. And then watch, as you can see, I've just opened up the multi-touch menu, and I can, to get rid of the multi-touch menu, I can tap and flick down. And that's the reason why I'm able to do that is I have multi-gestures turned on, but that gives you a good sense. I did all of this with one finger. So it's a good example of how the gesture system works. Now, notice that I still have those four fingers there. In order to turn off the gesture once it's activated, I need to tap on the Assistive Touch menu again and then tap in the center, and that deactivates the last gesture. One of the most extensive submenus of the Assistive Touch menu is the device submenu. So tap on the Assistive Touch button, tap on device, and you get the first of three submenus. In the upper left-hand corner is the lock screen. If I were to tap on this, this would do exactly the same thing that the wake sleep button does. And for the sake of this demonstration, I won't actually tap on it, but it would cause the screen to go blank and put the iPad to sleep. The next button over is the rotate screen submenu. So I'm going to tap on that, and you get four options, and then you're able to go back. So if I tap on portrait, you'll actually see the screen rotate, and then I can tap on left, and that will bring me back. But I can turn the screen in 360 degrees. Tap in the center to get back. The next button is the lock rotation button. If I tap on that, you'll see in the upper right-hand corner the lock rotation, and if I were to move the iPad, it would not rotate. So I'm going to unlock that. The next two buttons, before we get to the more button, is the volume up, volume down. So I'm going to tap twice on the volume up, and you'll see the volume will go up. Tap, tap, and the volume goes up. And I'm going to tap twice on the volume go down, and that will bring the volume down. So that's exactly like the hardware buttons. Next, when I hit the more button, I'm taken to another submenu. This is a new submenu to iOS 6, and this is a beta version of iOS 6, so this may not be the final configuration. But previously in iOS 5, I had the shake button, but it was in the first submenu and not in the sub-submenu. I do have three new options. Triple click on the home button. This button will mimic tapping on the home button three times. I need to, in accessibility program, to do something. I don't have a program to do here, but you could have a program to launch and deactivate Assistive Touch as an example. Take a screenshot. If I tap on that, I'm going to actually do that. Tap on it and take a screenshot. And it actually takes a screenshot. It shuts down the Assistive Touch menu and takes a screenshot of the actual screen. Device, more. Multitasking launches the multitasker. So I'm going to tap on that, and you can see that it brings up the multitasker. And if I tap it again, the same button again, it'll shut down the multitasker. So Assistive Touch, Device, More submenu, tap the multitasker, and it brings down and brings me back to where I was. And then the last one, Device, More, is Shake. Shake is supposed to, when the developer programs it to do so, Shake will actually mimic the device shaking. It doesn't actually shake the device. It just tells the program that the shake sensor has gone off. In a lot of testing, I was very excited about the shake button, because if you have this device mounted to a wheelchair, the shake button allows you to use applications that use the motion sensor. But in my testing, it really hasn't panned out that not every developer develops for it. So that's unfortunate. The last submenu I want to discuss is the favorite submenu, and that is where custom gestures can be accessed within the Assistive Touch menu. Tap on Assistive Touch and then tap on Favorites. Earlier I created a scroll down custom gesture, and that's where the star is. But default is this pinch gesture. So let me illustrate how to use pinch, and then I'll illustrate scroll down. So the best application I can think of to illustrate pinch is the photo album. So I'm going to tap out of Assistive Touch, I'm going to tap on Photos, and you're going to see our camera roll. I'm going to tap into one of the photographs to bring it up. And then I'm going to bring up the pinch gesture. So I'm going to tap on the Assistive Touch, tap on Favorites, and tap on Pinch. So scrolling out makes it bigger, scrolling in makes it smaller, and this is exactly what would happen if you were pinching with two fingers. Anywhere I tap, I still have the pinch gesture turned on. So I want to turn that off now because I want to show you the other gestures. So I tap on Assistive Touch and hit the center of the Assistive Touch menu, and that turns off the pinch gesture. Now the next one I want to show you, I'm going to get out to the home page and tap on the settings application. And you see how this, I'm using my finger to scroll up and down. See how long that is? Well, if you have a user that has a hard time with sort of fine motor, you can turn on Assistive Touch, turn on Favorites, and I'm going to show you that scroll down gesture I just made. And you can now tap, and it's going to scroll up every time. And there it is. And just by tapping on the screen once, I can scroll up. Same is true over here. One of the usage scenarios is evoking custom gestures that you've created. One of the hardest things to do when you first get an iPad, especially for a user who has fine motor issues, is unlocking the iPad when it's turned off. So once you turn it on, you got to unlock it to get in. What I've done is inside of Settings, under Accessibility here, under Assistive Touch, I've created a custom setting called Swipe Right. And we're going to use that to unlock the screen. So I'm going to go ahead and turn this off and then turn it back on by hitting the home button. And now I've got to unlock it. Well, if I have fine motor issues, I may have a hard time unlocking that lock. So I can tap on the Assistive Touch menu, tap on Favorites, and swipe right. And then all I have to do is tap the button, and it unlocks it for me. The next usage scenario I want to cover with Assistive Touch is the idea of button replacement. So I'm going to scroll and find an application here that has some music, and we'll use the Assistive Touch menu to control the volume buttons instead of the physical buttons. So let me show you. Tap on flashcards, and you can hear the music in the background. I can tap on the Assistive Touch menu, hit Device, and increase the volume or decrease the volume. And I can do this, I'm going to turn this all the way down, without even touching the buttons. For those users who have fine motor issues, tapping the volume button, especially inside of a case, can be very, very difficult. So this holds true for lock rotation, screen rotation. This holds true for a number of different things that using the little slider button may be a problem, or turning the device on or off. It may be just easier to hit a soft button on screen than it is to hit a hard button on the physical device. For a third Assistive Touch scenario, we're going to talk about multi-finger gestures. So I'm going to use one finger to tap on the four-finger gesture, and you can see on screen I have four fingers, 1, 2, 3, and I'm going to tap and flick up. And then watch, as you can see, I've just opened up the multi-touch menu, and I can to get rid of the multi-touch menu, I can tap and flick down. And that's the reason why I'm able to do that is I have multi-gestures turned on, but that gives you a good sense. I did all this with one finger. For more information, go to iPadsForSpecialNeedsBook.com, where you'll find more videos, other resources like cheat sheets, and a book on how to use the iPad for your special needs user.